And so that I don't miss it and you don't miss it, before I say anything more about confidence, I want to say this. Confidence is nothing more than a thought. It is a thought. Confidence is not a thing. It's not a place. It's not a person. It's a thought. Confidence is not a ball. Confidence isn't a trophy. Confidence isn't a fruit or a vegetable. Confidence isn't a cow. I'm being silly. Confidence is something that happens between your ears. It's a thing that happens in your mind. Confidence is a thought, and therefore confidence is a choice. You can pick to be confident. Now, confidence is not contingent on anything. What do I mean by that? Well, lots of times people will say, well, we need to have a great practice today so we can be confident for the game on Saturday. Or they say, well, we want to, at a couple games, we want to get these under our belt. We want to win these games to give us some confidence before we play a real tough opponent on Saturday. That something else is going to give us confidence. And people say that all the time. And because people don't know to argue back, they just accept it and know that must be right. He's smart. But it's nonsense. Did I say that? Well, I did. Why? Because confidence is a thought. What do we know about thoughts? We pick them. Now, what about this thing about having a good practice, though? Don't we want to have a good practice so we can be confident? I'd say, no. We want to have a good practice because we want to have a good practice. But we don't need to have a good practice to be confident because... So I think back, I'm going to share about my sport experience. I want you to think about yours. I have had practices, both as a player and a coach, where had a great practice and then performed great in the competition that followed. Okay? So that makes sense. I've had great practices and then performed poorly in the competition that followed. More to the point, I've had poor practices. I wanted to have a good practice, but didn't come out that way. I had a poor practice and then had a poor performance in the competition that followed as well. But what's really the point, and is the truth, is that I've had poor practices and then in the competition played great, maybe best ever. Now, I'm not saying go have a poor practice, get it out of the way so that you have great performance. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that, sure, have a great practice that may help me be confident going to the competition. But if I happen to not have a great practice, I surely don't want to have that make me think, now I cannot be confident going into the competition, because I want to be confident. Where confidence means I know I can get the best I have in me out of me. I can deliver my best. And gol darn it, that's a choice. And that's all it is. It's a choice. And this is the truth about confidence. Now, the real truth is it's two choices. And those two choices include the first, to understand that competence builds confidence. Competence builds confidence. In other words, if you get better at something, it's a whole lot easier to think you're going to do great. So first, choose to become more competent. If you want to be confident, choose to invest in yourself, practice great, get better, have more competence. It'll be easier for you then to choose to be confident. And you'll have a game there to back up your confidence. But in the end of the day, you can only get out what's in there, and we can always all get out everything that's in there. But if you put more in, and you know you put it in, not only is it going to be exciting, it's going to be motivating and easier to be confident you can get it out and let it out.